Polly Trottenberg graduating class of 1986, receiving the Barnard Woman of Achievement Award. First, let me express my gratitude to the Alumni Association for this wonderful honor. I'm especially humbled to join the company of previous awardees who are incredible leaders and visionaries in the arts, academia, journalism, philanthropy, and public service. The list includes some of my biggest idols, like Ruth Bader Ginsburg and Tozaki Shange and Suzanne Vega, who provided the soundtrack for my college and post-college years in New York City. And those years were so formative for me and led me to my love of cities, politics, and transportation, and my long public sector career. Like a lot of teenagers, I found my time at Barnard very foundational. I came not knowing who I was or what I wanted to be. I tried my hand at everything. Biology, political science, feminist literature, computer programming, Middle Eastern studies, you name it. But then I found my favorite subject, history. There were many amazing historians at Barnard and Columbia when I was a student, but my favorite was Mark Carnes, who was a relatively new professor when I took my first American History Survey course with him. I just loved it. I took many more history classes after that, including every course that Professor Carnes offered, from the Gilded Age to the Vietnam War. The study of history taught me so many skills that I've used throughout my career: critical thinking, persuasive writing, analyzing primary sources, pattern spotting, and connecting trends and events of the past with the social and political challenges of today. I also loved being in college in New York City. Admittedly, the 1980s were a much grittier time. There was a lot of crime and homelessness and other challenges. But there was also a lot of cultural and social and political activism and artistic expression. That time spurred me to get involved politically and become especially fascinated with how cities' transportation systems were built and operated, their impact on different communities, and how we could make them better. The explicitly feminist ethos of Barnard also made a lasting impression on me. The 1980s were a much less progressive time for women. Watch the popular films of the decade and you'll see what I mean. But being at Barnard gave me intellectual confidence and a desire to make my mark, particularly as a woman. From there, I've been so fortunate to have an amazing career in New York City, on Capitol Hill, and at the U.S. Department of Transportation, now serving as the Deputy Secretary. For me, there's nothing better than public service. It feeds the mind and the soul. So thank you again to the Barnard Alumni Association for this wonderful award. It's tremendously meaningful and special to me. I'm very humbled and grateful.